He has done great. Hey, put your hands together. Give him the glory. Just give him the glory. Give him the glory for the healing. Give him the glory for the breakthrough. Give him the glory for the deliverance. Give him the glory for the Lord. Give him the glory for his love that is flowing, flowing, flowing. Give him the glory this morning. He has not forsaken you. Give him the glory. He has left you out of the valley. Give him the glory. He has broken the church. Give him the glory. He has delivered you. We are free like a bird. Give him the glory. He has given us the assurance of victory. Give him the glory. His Holy Spirit is in us. Give him the glory this morning. Thank you, Father. We bless you, Lord. We bless you in your glory.
Let's go.
Spirit of the Lord say, there is a gushing of waters. The water is gushing out from the throne of God. And I ask the Lord what is happening. He said, it's my joy that is overflowing. It's my joy that is overflowing. I don't want you to miss this moment. If you are that one, I said, despite what I'm going through, irrespective of what I'm going, I want to drink from that water. I want you to come here right now, in this moment, as we pray for you. Joy! Joy that is overflowing. If you say, that is me, Lord, I want to be a partaker. Just come.
Yeah. Thank you for stepping in and showing up. Thank you for that joy. Thank you for deliverance that took place right now. Thank you for that anointing of acceleration. Divine speed that came in right now. We just want to bless you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Please be seated, be seated. Oh, we bless you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. We bless you. Mighty God, we magnify your name. He's a great and mighty God. Oh, what a presence, what a presence, what a presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we thank you. Mali Boso Tolobosi Kayabande O Rita Kayabashata Yiba Sakalaba. We are the generations that seek after you, Lord. We are the generation that worship you, the Spirit and the truth. Kalabro Soto Lipaliandere Eliko Soto Libashata Liadege. Manga kalide seni korobosi kayabashita. Those who seek you, you never put to shame. You are the wonder of those who diligently seek you. And we thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for your faithfulness, for your faithfulness, for your faithfulness. We bless you, Lord. Amen. Oh, God is good. God is good. God is good. Oh, he has proven himself once more. He has proven his faithfulness once more. And we just want to say thank you. I bless the name of the Lord this morning. Amen. Amen. I once again greet each and every one of you. I thank you for being here. You're being here, the Lord has ordered yourselves, and may the Lord bless you. Thank you, prophetess, and to me for leading us in that powerful worship. I also appreciate the program leader, the prayer leader. Thank you for powerful prayer. The presence of God is so tangible. I thank God for everyone, and also for my daughter sitting there. Thank you for coming with our granddaughter to visit us. Hallelujah. May the Lord continue to bless you. Amen. Amen. I also welcome all those who are online. May the Lord bless you real good. Hallelujah. It has been a wonderful month, and we are ending this month of prayer. Hallelujah. Today is day 29. God has been good, and he has been so faithful. I appreciate everyone that woke up 12 a.m. in the morning to join. I appreciate you, and I know the good work the Lord has started, he will surely complete it. Amen. And like we announced yesterday, whatever you do, make sure you wake up on the 30th. Don't miss this last day, because the end of the matter is greater than the beginning. Amen. Like I said, even if you wake up, you are under your blanket, even if it is one eye that is open, just make sure your spirit is open. Hallelujah. Just connect. Just connect. Amen. And today we are also celebrating the gift of the Lord to us as human beings. We are celebrating Christ today, the birth of Christ, and I will just be ministering briefly, and after that, we're going to fellowship with each other. Please don't run away. We're going to fellowship. We're going to feast before many of us start to travel back to our various home to celebrate the Christmas and end of the year with the family. Let's go straight to the word of God this morning. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, help me. I do not want to take long, because majority of the work has been done. It has been done. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 1, verse 23. Matthew chapter 1, verse 23. Matthew 1, 23. This is the story of Angel Gabriel that appeared to the Virgin Mary. And he began to deliver the message from the Lord to Virgin Mary. And in verse 23, the angel recalled the prophecy that was given. And he said, "Behold,
The virgin shall be with a child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel. Somebody say Emmanuel. Emmanuel. Which is translated God with us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This morning I will be talking about Emmanuel, God with us. And if God is with all of us, it means God is also for me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, bless the reading of your word. Speak to us this morning. Do what no man can do. At the end of the day, after you have touched the people, after there is deliverance, after there is perfection, after crooked ways have been made straight, oh Lord, take all the glory. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. So this morning, we just want to thank God, our Father, for his love and for his mercy. We are here standing at the end of November, waving goodbye to January to this November, saying the Lord has carried us through. We did not prepare for COVID-19. COVID-19 came like a storm, but we are standing strong. Hallelujah. We are still standing here, and we just thank God for his grace that has carried us through. That grace that brought us to this end of November, that grace will make us finish. And we will not just finish, we will finish well in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The promise of the Lord for us this morning, as he deposited joy in our heart, is to refresh us. And today, this morning, I declare that you shall be refreshed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Do you know what refresh is? For those who work on the computer, if your computer sometimes has work and is hungry, you click the refresh button. Everything comes back into normal and they begin to work. You have tried, you have cried, you have worked hard. But the Lord said, this morning, I am refreshing you. That's why before the message, he poured out his water and he said, that is the joy that I'm pouring out. Receive that refreshing in the name of Jesus. In this service, the hand of the Lord will rest upon you. The hand of the Lord will restore you. The hand of the Lord will rejuvenate you. And it will give you rest on all sides in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. So we are chosen today to celebrate the birth of Christ Jesus. We are having our Christmas today. Hallelujah. For some, Christmas is about eating and drinking. But Christmas is not just about that. Hallelujah. There are people who are caught up in the theology and the history surrounding the birth of Jesus Christ. I describe those people looking at the donut and saying there is a hole in the donut. Excuse me, a donut is a donut. Yeah. Whether it has a hole or no hole, yeah. Just eat the donut and enjoy. But they are caught up about the date, about the history, that they are missing the most important thing about the birth of Christ. Hallelujah. However, what is Christmas? What is the celebration of Christ? Hallelujah. Christmas is about coming to man to do for man what man cannot do by himself. We are trapped in sin. So God sent his only son to deliver us from sin. Hallelujah. That is what Christmas is all about. John chapter 3 verse 16 says, for God greatly loved the world so dearly that he gave his precious son, his only begotten son he gave, that whosoever believes, whosoever trusts him as a savior will not perish, but have eternal life. Hallelujah. I wish we are having Bible study and I'll start to break this thing down. Because when you talk about eternal life, people don't understand what is this eternal life. It is very, you see, Jesus said, my yoke is not burdensome. In John chapter 17, verse 3, Jesus defined eternal life. He said that they might know him as the only true God. That is eternal life. When you know God as the only true God, you do what he wants you to do. You benefit from everything he has given to you.
That is eternal life. Then you enjoy the life intended for you as designed by God in heaven. So God gave us the soul because in our own self we cannot access that eternal life. But he gave us this precious gift so that we can accept and enjoy that eternal life. That is what Christmas is all about. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Many people say there is no need to celebrate the birth of Christ. We only focus on the death and resurrection. Yes, glory be to God. But if the child was not born, the child would not have been able to die. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I've read about history of so many African countries that were under the oppression and they are crying out for freedom. And when the enemy hold them in captivity and they heard that a force is coming from somewhere, the moment the military guys enter the zone or the territory, the people will line up in the village and they are rejoicing. They are rejoicing. Why? Because they know these people are coming to deliver us. Hallelujah. They have not defeated the enemy, but they are already rejoicing because they know this United Nations envoy that came, they are coming to do something. So at the birth, at the arrival of the child, we need to celebrate because we know he who began a good work will surely complete it. Hallelujah. So when we talk about Christmas, the birth of Christ is not simply a story to admire. Yeah. Oh, wow, a Virgin Mary gave birth to a child. It's more than that. It's not a story to admire. The shepherd, while they watched their flock by night, the angel of the Lord appeared and they saw the sign and they went. It's not a story to admire. The Christmas story, the story about the birth of Christ, is a story that transforms. It transforms life. It changes life. And as we talk about this story, as we celebrate the birth of Christ, as we remember the love of God, may that story transform your life. In the name of Jesus. There are so many truths that surround the birth of Christ. And today I want to share with you one of that truth. One of that truth that surrounds the birth of Christ. And it is my desire, it is my prayer that that truth will make you free. That truth will translate you into freedom. John chapter 8 verse 32 says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Hallelujah. Somebody is in the oppression of the enemy. Somebody is in the bondage of the enemy. You have been kept in the dark. But today, the Lord shall reveal the truth to you, and the truth shall make you free. In the name of Jesus, you will be free from the lies of the enemy. You will be free from the bondage of the enemy. You will be free from the attack of the enemy. You will be able to live life in abundance because of the truth that is in the word of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Emmanuel, God with us. Somebody say Emmanuel. God is with me. So the Bible says God loves you so much that he gave you that precious son, his only son. Can you just take a moment and appreciate God and say, Lord, thank you. Thank you for your son. Thank you for Jesus. If I were the only one on earth, he would still have come anyway. Thank you, thank you. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for Zoe life. Thank you for abundant life. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says this child is given a name by God himself. Before he was born, a name was given, and that name is Emmanuel, and that name means God with us. Hallelujah. So what God is saying is that I love you so much, and by giving you this son, I am with you. I am with you 24/7. I am with you. I'm not just with you on Sunday when you come to church. On Monday when you go home, I am with you. I am with you all the days of your life. To know that God is with you is the greatest blessing. Hallelujah. If you can understand that everywhere I go, in whatever I experience, whether I am on the mountain, whether I am in the valley, God is there dwell with you is the greatest blessing of all time. Hallelujah. David knew this truth, and he took comfort in this truth. That's why he declared in Psalm 23, he said, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you are with me. He knows that in the valley of shadow of death, there are so many evils, but he said, I shall not fear. Why? Because God is with me. Hallelujah. And this is the blessing we celebrate today. This is what we celebrate today. This is the truth we are celebrating, that God is with us. Hallelujah. God sent his son to come and be with us. His name is Emmanuel. This prophecy that we read in Matthew was given years ago in Isaiah chapter 7. That a child is coming and his name will be Emmanuel. And the prophecy came to pass. Can I pause there and tell you and remind you that God is faithful to his word? His word that he spoke will surely come to pass. Those who get the prophecy have died, but the word of God still remains. Men were crying, we are under the bondage, and they were saying, Lord, we need deliverance. And he said, the son is coming. Many generations pass by, but the word of God remains. I speak over your life this morning. As we celebrate the birth of this risen King, every word of God spoken over your life will surely come to pass in the name of Jesus. As you celebrate the gift of life, as you celebrate the truth that is in the word of God, his word will surely come to pass in your life. Hallelujah. This son came to be with us. And he said, the devil has come to kill, to steal, to destroy. But I, Jesus, I come to give you life, give you a abundance. I am not sitting in Kleinekope with life in abundance while you are in Korea Capital. I am there with you to give you life in abundance. I am in you to give you life in abundance. I am with you. And you need to understand, when God is with you, he sees all things that are happening. He sees what the enemy is doing. He sees the attack of the enemy. He sees the frustration. He sees how they have been bullying you. But today, somebody say today, his presence shall magnify in my life. His presence shall manifest in my life in the name of Jesus. Maybe the enemy has come to kill. Maybe he has stolen something. I don't know what he has stolen. Maybe it's your job. Maybe it's your business. Maybe it's your promotion. Maybe it's whatever belongs to you. You know what the enemy has tampered with. But today, I want you to stand on the truth. Jesus is with me. Emmanuel. And because he is with me, he will settle all that concerns me. If you read in the scripture, anytime Jesus steps in a place and he sees chaos, he sees the work of the enemy, he doesn't close his eyes, he moves away. I just move away. He will always do something. When he was preaching to about 5,000 people and more, he saw they were hungry. He fed them. Are you hungry for something this morning? As you are sitting here, the Lord is feeding you in the name of Jesus. He saw the only son of a widow in name being taken to the burial ground. He looked at them. He said, stop. He brought down the coffin. He broke protocol and he raised the child up. He entered the house of Jairus. They said, the child is dead. He said, the child is not dead. The child is only sleeping. He entered. He said, damsel, Talitha kumi, rise up and leave. The child came to life. He came across Bartimaeus, the blind man. He received his sight. He met a woman at a well in Samaria, and he restored the life of that woman. A woman who is a fugitive. She became an evangelist. Jesus is with you. Jesus is here. He is supplying all your needs in the name of Jesus. I see restoration taking place. I see restoration taking place. I see restoration taking place in the name of Jesus. Amen. The Bible said in 1 John chapter 1, verse 3, the second part. He said, for this reason, somebody say, for this reason.
For this reason.
For this reason. For this reason, for what you are going through right now. For the challenges you are going through now. For the attack you are going through now. For this reason, the Son of God was made manifest so that the works of the enemy can be destroyed. This morning, every work of the enemy is being destroyed. Every agenda of the enemy is hereby overthrown. Every orchestration of darkness in your life is hereby overthrown. In the name of Jesus, every enemy that gathered and said you will not see the end of December, and say you will not rejoice, and say you will not get back that which was stolen from you, this morning, I call the host of angels to go into the manufacturing center of God and manufacture high-grade shame over the enemy in the name of Jesus. Shame shall be the apostle. All your enemy will close their eyes and they will run away in shame in the name of Jesus. The word of God said they will come. Yes, they will come. But they will only come in one place. They will attack you only one place. They will penetrate only one place. But in seven directions, they will flee. That shall be your question. That shall be your question. Why? Because Emmanuel, God is with us. Romans chapter 8, verse 31. He says, what then shall we say to these things? What then shall we say to the attacks of the enemy? What then shall we say to the intimidation of the enemy? What then shall we say to what the enemy is planning? He said, if God is for us, who can be against us? Child of God, I want you to know this truth this morning. I want you to hold on to this truth this morning. If God is with you, if God is for you, no harm of the enemy can come near you. They will make noise. They are wasting their time. In gathering, they shall gather, but it's not of the Lord. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. As the enemy is forming the weapon, AK-47, the bazooka, the bomb, you are watching them, and they put your name, amen, as the targets. Don't worry, amen. Don't fear, amen. Just say, God is with me, amen. God is with me, amen. He who sits in heaven, and the earth is footstool, he is with me, he will give me victory, amen. Hallelujah. David knew that God was with him. That's why he was able to confront Goliath. Imagine David, he had no sword. And he was boasting. He said, Goliath, this giant, I will cut off your head. No sword. He said, I will cut off your head. Because he knew God is with me. Even if I go through the valley of shadow of death, even if I face the Goliath, God is with me. I am not even going to be protected from the giant. He said, I will cut off your head. What happened? Goliath fell down and he realized, hey, I have declared the word. I will cut off the head of this Goliath. Yeah. Wait a minute, I've got no sword. Yeah. And the Lord opened his eyes and said, take the sword of the enemy. Use it to cut off the head. Yeah. Hallelujah. God with us. God with me. Emmanuel. 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 Child of God, when you know God is with you, you don't need to fear. You and fear should not be the same WhatsApp group. Go. Remove your name from that group. Remove your name from that WhatsApp group. The WhatsApp group of those who fear. So that when the enemy is sending his memo, when he's sharing his message, you don't receive it. Don't just mute it. Remove your name and delete that number. Exit that group. Exit that group. In the name of Jesus. In the register of those the enemy have targeted to destroy this year, I remove your name from it. I remove the name of your family from it. I remove the name of those who are close to you from it. In the name of Jesus. When the angel of darkness is going around sharing his own Christmas package, sorrow, pain, disappointment, they will not locate your address. I delete your address from the register of the enemy. Are you financially stressed this morning? Hear the word of God. Emmanuel, God is with you. Are you going through any challenges this morning? Hear the word of God. God is with you. In Isaiah 41 verse 10, he said, fear not. Somebody say, fear not. Say, fear not. I am with you. Do not be dismayed. I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my strong right hand. Zephaniah chapter 3 verse 17 says, the Lord is in your midst. A mighty one who will save. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will quiet you by his love. And he will exalt over you with loud singing, which means when God is with you, he will be doing some great things. He will make sure you sing songs of praise. He will give you a reason to testify. He will give you a reason to dance. He will give you a reason to celebrate. That is your portion this morning in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This morning, that is the message I have for you. Emmanuel, God is with us. Emmanuel, God is with me. It doesn't matter what I'm going through. God is with me. And if he's with me, he knows what is happening. He knows my tomorrow. And he knows what to do. Hallelujah. Amen. He loves you so much. That's why he sent you his son as a special gift. Receive this gift. Receive this gift. And the truth that comes with this gift. Hallelujah. And enjoy life in abundance. This morning, as you've heard the word, are you sitting here not having this gift? Not receiving this gift fully. And that is the Son of God. For those of us who are here in the house and those who are online, wherever you are watching from, have you received this precious gift into your heart? Have you accepted this Jesus? Have you accepted Emmanuel into your heart? That is the only time that you can enjoy the rest, the peace, the joy that comes with Emmanuel. Let's rise on our feet as we pray this morning. Halabo se kayaba shata. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Let's close our eyes. I want to give permission to someone, those who are here and those who are online. If you say, I've not received this gift, Emmanuel, this God, I've not opened my heart to him, but I want to give him a chance. I want to invite him into my heart. I want to receive him so that I cannot fear, so that the power of fear can be broken, so that I can enjoy all the benefit that comes with the truth. If you are that one, wherever you are, just lift up your hand as we close our eyes. Hallelujah. Thank you for those hands. And thank you for those hands. Just lift up the hand as I'm going to pray for you. And those who are online, wherever you are, distance is not a barrier. Just lift up your hands. Or perhaps at one time you have received it, but somehow you have departed from him. And you say, I want to make my way back to him. Hallelujah. For those who lift up their head, just say this prayer after me. Hallelujah. Say, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. Thank you for availing yourself as a gift to come and die for me. Today, I appreciate you and I confess with my mouth that Jesus, you are Lord. I believe in my heart that you saved me. You died for me. You shed your blood for me. I accept you into my heart. I will serve you all the days of my life, and I will never remain the same. I am now a child of God. I'm coming back home. Receive me and install me, establish me in your kingdom, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, I thank you for those who prayed. Seal them with the mark of the Holy Spirit. Let your word come to pass in their life. We persuade the plans and the agenda of the enemy. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Just put your hands together. Hallelujah. Emmanuel, God with us. David said, because God is with me, I shall fear no evil. I want you to pray for yourself. I refuse to be afraid of any evil. I refuse to panic of any negative news, because God is with me. Emmanuel.